What is up? Welcome back to my channel. Today I have a little daily vlog for you guys. I'm kind of starting this a little later than I typically do. It's about 2:30 in the afternoon on a Sunday, which I love. I've had a wonderful lazy Sunday morning, as you can tell by my very messy bun. But I thought I would turn on the camera because we are packing for Nashville. So I'm driving to Nashville on Wednesday, which is gonna be a whole nother vlog, doing the 12 hours by myself. I just first and foremost wanna say this trip is in no way a vacation. If I didn't have to travel, I would not be traveling right now, which is why I'm choosing to drive rather than fly, because I just don't feel safe kind of being around a ton of people on a plane right now. I'd rather just be by myself in a car for an extended period of time. Basically, I just have a few things that I need to like either renew or get done in Nashville that I cannot do over the internet. So I'm driving down rather than flying, just to eliminate exposure between me and others. But it will still be nice to see my family for a few days, you know, probably just bounce back and forth between my mom's house and my dad's apartment and really not go anywhere. But I thought I would kind of take you guys along with me while I pack for this week, just because I feel like I haven't done a pack with me ever before, and if I have, it was like years ago on my channel. Okay, but first and foremost, how cute. What is she doing? Are you shy? What's going on? Are you shy, little girl? No, you're not. You're just sleepy. Oh, so sweet. Oh, thank you. We took Dakota on a walk before Kevin went to work. So now it's just me and her, but while I pack, hopefully she'll have a nice little nap. So sweet, thank you. She licks my hands and my feet like all the time. I'm only going for literally like 7 days, so I'm not packing a lot. I do have to bring some stuff down for my sister because she is still in Nashville, since her college here in New York is not back open, obviously. But I thought it would still be interesting to kind of see what I'm packing. I'm not bringing any like real outfits. It's mostly just loungewear and workout clothes because I still want to work out while I'm there. So I'm bringing this backpack, which is gonna be like all of my tech stuff and just things that I'm gonna need with me like in the car. And then this is from Baze, which I absolutely love this brand. It's by Shay Mitchell. This is their, I believe it's their like weekender bag. And you can loop this onto like the back of your suitcase too. I bought this like a year ago thinking I would be doing a lot of traveling in 2020, but it's actually been a great investment. It literally holds so much. It has this pocket down below that you can use for shoes. It's been in the closet for a little bit, so it's a little smushed, but it will take its shape once I stuff it. I think this is around $100. Literally, I love this. It can hold so much. So if you're going away for a week, this is perfect. Okay, so I have my packing list on my phone. That's how I always like to do it. So first and foremost, I'm actually going to grab my Vans from over here. I'm literally just bringing these and then my Nikes for working out. So I'm gonna be gone for 7 days. If this was a normal trip, I would pack 7 full outfits, but because it's mostly just gonna be chill at home, I'm okay with re-wearing a few pieces. So this is actually the outfit that I'm gonna wear in the car. I do need to pack this, but this is a little misguided set that I'm gonna be wearing in the car. And then these are some of the outfits that I'm bringing. As you can tell, most of them are workout clothing items, just because again, I wanna be comfy, but I also wanna make sure that I do work out every day while I'm there. So I have this little red set from Lululemon. It's not actually a real set, but I bought it to kind of make it my own little set. I have a camo set from Lululemon as well. As you guys can tell, kind of my go-to. 2 black sports bras and a pair of Wonder Unders. I do want to bring my bike shorts because it might be kind of like semi-warm one day I'm there. And then my Lulu Define jacket. I realized that I want to pack the sweater that I'm wearing today, so I'm just in my sports bra right now, which is totally fine, but I'm gonna pack this in a second. But what I also need to do is go into me and Ava's old room where I have like my clothes for right now and grab a couple t-shirts. Yeah, so I'll just grab these 3, black, white, and a gray t-shirt. Okay, so next is some beauty stuff and some like skincare hair stuff that I have to bring. I am pretty much all done packing up my makeup. The only thing that I have to wait and put in this travel bag is my powder brush and my Glossier skin tint, because I have to wear foundation tomorrow and powder tomorrow, just because I'm gonna be on camera for a producing gig. So I'm gonna leave that out, and then as soon as I'm done with my makeup tomorrow morning, I'm going to put it here in this bag. This seems like a lot of makeup. It's actually not all makeup, so it's just like a very basic everyday face look. Like literally I didn't bring any eyeshadow or anything. It's just like face makeup. And then I have some skincare and stuff in here as well, and a couple miniature hair care products that are coming with me. I'm almost out of my Curology face wash, so last night I went to CVS and picked up a little travel size. It's from CeraVe cleanser in case I run out while I'm in Nashville, because I don't want to have to go out while I'm there. I also have some teeth whitening strips because I'm in the process of doing like a 10-day whitening thing, just because I realized my teeth need to be touched up a little bit. It's been like over 2.5 years since I've done any sort of whitening on them, so figured couldn't hurt to have some nice looking teeth for the holiday season. I have a new journal here with me because I literally just have two more pages in my current journal, and I want to make sure I have my journal while I am away. This is so pretty. I actually got it at Papyrus right before all of the locations closed down, but I think it's really pretty. I need to bring a metal hair clip with me because that's how I put my hair up usually for most days. And then I'm also going to make sure and I bring a couple hair ties. So I think I'm actually gonna put the hair clip and the hair ties in here. And then, like I said, I'll put the rest of my makeup in there tomorrow morning. So for now, I'm going to bring all of this into the bedroom to pack it away. These are just some hair care products and a couple skincare things too. My makeup removing balm, my Clarisol acne pads, and then some Nivea body cream. Obviously, if I was flying, I would make sure to bring like travel sizes of everything, but since I'm not, it's just easier to like throw the whole like product in the bag without having to like worry about transferring it into a travel friendly container. This might be a really dumb idea to balance this all on my journal, but we're living on the edge, people. Okay, so everything else I'm gonna have to wait until the night before to pack, just because it's things that I'm going to need tomorrow and Tuesday. Next, I'm actually going to get a suitcase ready because I have to bring some stuff down for my sister Ava, like I said. And I'm also going to put this in the suitcase. I actually recently, as of probably the last year or something, have had a little bit of an issue when it comes to my sciatic nerve. So I actually ordered this seat cushion off of Amazon to bring with me in the car so that I'm very comfortable during this 12-hour drive. Both my parents were like, that's a great idea, you should buy it. So I'm gonna put it in the suitcase because it's obviously a bigger item, but I'm gonna take it out as soon as I get my rental car. And then I'm actually gonna start putting together my backpack, which like I said is where all my tech stuff is gonna go. And I realized I should probably just do this today to kind of like get ahead. I want to make sure that my portable charger is charged 100% and ready to go, just because I don't know if I'm gonna be able to charge my phone in the car. You just never know if there's gonna be an issue. I also have a MoFi case on my iPhone, which holds like a full charge worth for my phone, so hopefully we will be all good on this road trip. I just feel like you can never be too prepared because you never know if you're gonna get stuck in traffic and it's gonna take you longer than you anticipated. Look at my sweet little girl. Now I do want to bring some masks because obviously there are a few things that I have to go do while I'm in Nashville. They are outside, but obviously you need to mask up. So I'm bringing my three favorites from Reuse Masks LA. I talk about these all the time. And you know what I'll do actually is I'm gonna put this gray one with my stuff that I'm wearing the day of the drive, just so that I have a mask ready to go. And then I'll put these two in my backpack. Another little tech item that I know I'm gonna need, my little mini vlog tripod. I'm obviously not planning on filming any main channel videos, or not main channel, I mean like sit down videos, but I am planning on vlogging while I'm there, and I do need to film like a low buy update while I'm there. Now I wasn't planning on bringing this originally, this being my podcast microphone, but I actually have to because I have a very exciting guest interview one of the days that I'm in Nashville. It's not an in-person interview, she actually lives up here in New York, but I didn't want to move the date on her just because I felt like that wasn't professional. So I'm gonna bring my podcast mic down, and maybe if, you know, inspiration strikes, I will record a solo episode while I'm down there too. I just plugged in my Kindle as well because I realized I'm insanely busy these next few days. I'm probably not gonna use it until I'm in Nashville, and I still have a actual like physical book that I'm not done reading yet. So if I have time like tonight or tomorrow, I'll just read that book because it's really good and I haven't finished it yet. So once these two devices are done charging, I will put them in my my tech backpack. Okay, so I think that's kind of it for now. I know that it wasn't like a complete full pack with me, but I did as much as I could. Pretty much all I have left to pack is like my tech items that I'm gonna need for the next 2 days. So my camera, my laptop, my phone, obviously. I'll pack up my makeup tomorrow, and then I will put my skincare in this bag here on Tuesday night after I do my skincare routine before bed. I look so good right now, but it's literally just a chill day at home, so I don't know. Why do I have to look like a movie star? Why can't I just look like a thumb? It is about 4:15 now, and I didn't have lunch. I had an early breakfast, and then I kind of skipped lunch, so now I'm like, do I eat dinner? Do I have a snack? I think I'm just gonna go ahead and do a meal. Kevin and I got our groceries in last night, and we pretty much just ordered for him because I'm only gonna be here for 2 more days. So I did something really bad, and I just got microwavable meals, which is fine. It's fine like once in a while. You just don't want it to be an everyday thing. And so I think I'm going to do this Amy's 3 cheese and kale bake bowl. I used to get these in high school. I used to love these things. So I'm gonna eat that, and then if I get hungrier later on in the evening, I'll just have like either a little small meal or a snack or something. But yeah, going to eat that, and then I actually have to edit a solo podcast episode that is going up while I'm in Nashville, so I can't skip out on that. So I'm gonna like edit it, add in like the ad spots, and then pre-upload it onto Anchor. I'll show you guys everything that I can without showing anything that's like going to like show you guys the inner workings of like Anchor and, I don't know, like security issues. Am I making sense? I don't even think that sentence made sense. Basically what I'm saying is I just don't want to show you guys anything that has to do with my account security. Also, Dakota is going wild for her new toy. Kevin got this for her a few days ago. It's like this dragon, and she is so in love. It's the cutest thing. Okay, the smell of this like cheesy kale noodle goodness just sent me right back to high school. Kinda not mad at it though, because I'm so excited. Even though this does not look the most appetizing, I swear it is so good. Comment down below if you have had this before. The end right here got a little burnt. I don't know how, because I microwaved it for actually less time than they suggested, but nevertheless, time to dig in. I've got my little assistant here with me. I love her from behind. Her little ears are so cute. Oh my gosh. Anyways, so here is my podcast editing setup. You guys know I use GarageBand, just because it's really easy to use. I've known how to use this for years and years. I think it's one of the first applications I ever like taught myself how to use on like my first Mac desktop, because I didn't even get a laptop first. Anyways, so I'm going to edit this. I'm like 10 minutes in. I think it's gonna end up being like a 40 minute episode. And then wherever I think would be a good like marker for an ad, and I have this whole little podcast folder. Yes, with the subject for this podcast is what I've learned about myself 8 months into quarantine. And I literally just type out where I want the ad slots to be. That way, once I upload this into Anchor, it's a lot easier to put in the ad segments. Okay, so it actually took me a little while longer than I thought it would, because my mom actually ended up calling me. But the podcast is done being edited. It was just uploaded into Anchor. So now I am adding the splits in the episode, and then going to add the ad segments. There's one, and there's two. Okay, so once those new segments save, I can add the little ad spots. I hope this vlog hasn't been like too all over the place or too boring for you guys. I just really wanted to like film something today, and I was in the mood to film, but I was like, I don't know if this is gonna be the most exciting day, but we're getting a lot done. Also, I look absolutely crazy right now. I'm back in my sports bra because I was just so hot from like working on my computer, because it gets really warm, that I was like, you know what, sports bra it is. And now I just have to, kind of like YouTube, add the title and the description slash like the show notes, and then pre-schedule it to go up in November, which is crazy. I cannot believe it's gonna be November by the time I upload this episode. And we are ready to go. Ordinary peel, just solid, such a staple in my skincare routine. My skin, man, it has just been an interesting time because I feel like for the last 6 months, my skin has just looked amazing, like probably the best it's ever looked. And then I switched my Curology prescription because I was noticing that I was getting a little bit of like fungal acne meets maskne, which I've never obviously dealt with before. And so my Curology provider changed the prescription, and it's been a little over 2 months, and I feel like my skin has not only not gotten used to it, but it just doesn't look good. So I actually just messaged my Curology provider last night, and we are just gonna go back to my normal prescription this next shipment, but it doesn't come to me for like another 2 weeks. So right now it's just all about kind of preventing and keeping my skin at bay. I don't wanna stop using the Curology altogether because I don't want my skin to like not remember it. Skincare is a process, and I know that literally the only reason I'm having these issues right now is because of wearing a mask. I know that if we didn't have to do that, I wouldn't be dealing with any of this, which is obviously fine. Like, we need to wear a mask, no excuse for not wearing one. It doesn't necessarily look bad. I mean, I have this like one little zit that's still healing. It just like left a scar. I don't think it looks bad. I'm just dealing with different pimples and like different kinds of breakouts than I ever have before. And they're small, but they mess with the texture of my skin. So it just like, it bothers me. You know, I don't know if it's like the most noticeable, but I notice it. Anyways, this stuff usually always helps. I think I'm actually gonna put a little bit extra on my cheeks because they do need some extra love right now. All right, so I'm gonna leave this on. I brushed my teeth like 10 minutes ago. I have to wait like 20 more minutes before I put my whitening strips in, but then I'll obviously show you guys those and link them down below if I remember. And yeah, we're gonna have ourselves a night. Gonna watch the final episode of Schitt's Creek because it just came out on Netflix. I'm really not emotionally ready, but I know we have to finish it. I already cried last night watching the second to last episode. Complete wreck. So I know tonight is probably just gonna be full on waterworks because that show will forever have my heart. Already, I feel like my skin just looks so much brighter and smoother. Like, it's literally, I think, an instant result when you use this mask. And then obviously when you use it over time, it just like really helps your skin. But okay, now it's time for my teeth whitening. So these are the white strips that I am using right now. Obviously this is not like sponsored at all. I used to use Smile Brilliant from a collaboration a long time ago, and I fell in love with them and I just continued to use them, but I ran out of the gel and I didn't really feel like repurchasing it right now. I just wanted something quick that would only take a few days. So I got the Crest white strips for sensitive teeth. I don't have sensitive teeth, but I figured these can tend to be a little harsh on anybody, so I wanted to try out the sensitive version. I'm on day 3. My teeth and my gums feel great. This obviously like isn't something that I do every single month or anything like that. Like I said, the last time I like whitened my teeth was probably like 2 years ago. My teeth are generally pretty white. I don't drink coffee, so my teeth aren't really stained or anything, but I was looking at them and I was like, you know what, we're entering the holiday season. Why not just kind of refresh my smile a little bit? So I'm just gonna leave them on for half an hour and I'm going to finish my skincare routine. Oh, let me talk about this before I put my whitening strips in, because I do get a little bit of a lisp. Twice a week, rather than using my normal nighttime moisturizer, which is this one from Elta MD, I love this stuff, but twice a week, instead of using that, I use the Dr. Brandt Hydrobiotic Recovery Sleeping Mask instead. I was recommended this about a month ago from a friend of mine who is a makeup artist. This stuff is incredible. I believe this is a Clean at Sephora product too. Don't quote me on that. But it's basically just an ultra hydrating sleeping mask, but it's a gel formula. So for combo to oily skin, it's just everything. It smells so clean, like a spa. And I feel like my skin just looks so refreshed and plumped, and I even feel like my breakouts aren't as inflamed when I wake up in the morning. So I'll link this down below too. It's a little expensive, but a little goes a long way. And like I said, I only use it like twice a week. They say you can use it every night, kind of in lieu of your nighttime moisturizer, but I love the Elta MD stuff that I use, so I like to kind of go back and forth. So yeah, gonna put all of that on. Also my Curology prescription, do a little time lapse, and then we will just sit and wait for my teeth whitening strips to work.